When it comes to responding to emerging threats, the Pentagon's Director for Electromagnetic Warfare suggested today that the US military's electronic warfare organization should borrow technology from SpaceX. SpaceX founder Elon Musk said that Russia had jammed Starlink terminals in Ukraine for hours at a time after SpaceX shipped Starlink terminals to Ukraine in February in an apparent effort to help Ukraine preserve its internet connection amid the war with Russia. Starlink was back up and running after a software upgrade, according to Musk, who added on March 25 that the Constellation had resisted all hacking and jamming attempts in Ukraine. Assuming Musk, who is known for being a showboater in his public pronouncements, is giving an accurate image, a private company tweeted Russian electromagnetic wave attempts with software updates is the kind of thing that makes Pentagon electromagnetic wave experts sit up and take notice. That's wonderful from the standpoint of an electromagnetic warfare technologist. Dave Tremper, head of electronic warfare for the Pentagon's acquisition office, remarked, "That paradigm and how they executed that is sort of eye-watering to me. We need to be able to upgrade in the same way that Starlink was able to when a threat appeared. We need to be able to modify our electromagnetic posture quickly, and we need to be able to change what we're attempting to do without sacrificing capabilities." Since Russia's 2014 seizure of Crimea, the Russian military has utilized electronic warfare extensively in Ukraine's Donbas region, frequently to great effect, employing electromagnetic signals to disclose Ukrainian forces' positions and disable equipment like drones. The current battle, on the other hand, maybe expose the limits of Russia's electromagnetic warfare capability. Russia's continuous incursion deep into Ukraine, according to Tremper, is a completely different scenario than previous operations, which were primarily limited to the border between Russia and contested parts of Ukraine. I think electromagnetic warfare coordination and synchronization become quite tough when you're attempting to reach the middle of that country. It becomes considerably more difficult to enter those urban environments, he remarked. And I believe what we're seeing in Ukraine is a resistance, where there isn't a reliance on the electromagnetic spectrum. Another issue for Russia's military has been a lack of training and expertise, which has been painfully evident even outside the realm of electronic warfare, with major embarrassments, such as the sinking of the Russian warship Moskva, the Russian Air Force's inability to achieve air superiority against an adversary with far fewer combat aircraft, and ongoing logistics failures that have resulted in memes depicting Ukrainian farmers driving away with their livestock. Tremper stated, "I suppose we expected a lot larger electromagnetic warfare presence. Which isn't to say it isn't there," says the author, "but I believe the degree of coordination and synchronization of these types of activities is such that an untrained operator will have a difficult time carrying off such occurrences properly." The Air Force's Director of Electromagnetic Spectrum Superiority, General Tad Clark, prefaced his remarks by admitting that he couldn't go into specifics about what the US has learned about Russia's electronic warfare threat from its actions in Ukraine. He did point out, however, that those actions do more than just provide information about Russia's technological capabilities. They also provide a picture of whether Russia has the financial resources to carry out the task. "We're learning a lot about what Russia has been putting their money on, the sophistication and reliability of their equipment, and their ability to execute that objective in a coordinated manner," he said. "It provides us an idea of where particular countries are, where we are, where we need to be, and where we want to be," says the general.